Hello and welcome to Her Crypto Night, where we'll be discussing ideas for marketing crypto to women. Today's presentation is brought to you by Beauty of Crypto. Beauty of Crypto is seeking to spread adoption of cryptocurrency by promoting women in the crypto industry and creating a space where they can network. You can find out more about Beauty of Crypto on their website, beautyofcrypto.com, as well as RSVP for any upcoming meetings. So why would we want to focus on marketing crypto to women? Well, the answer is quite simple. Tonight in our discussion, we're going to go over general marketing, and in particular, we'll look at the traditional marketing, the start of a transformation that recently happened, and why marketing is changing today. We'll also discuss marketing as applied to investing. We will discuss the takeaway, what you can get from this presentation, and we'll go over three action steps that you can use in your business today. After that, we'll open up for discussion. And if you're not in our meeting live, we'd love for you to leave comments and we'll be sure to review those and respond. But we want to get feedback as well from everyone. So again, why market to women? Well, women make up roughly half of the entire world's population. There are all over the place. 40% of US businesses are owned by women. Of single home buyers, more are women. And one interesting statistic, 94% of 15 to 35 year old women shop online for over an hour a day. So it's a great market to market to in general, but particularly for crypto and if we're seeking to spread adoption. So understanding what makes women tick, there are all sorts of different profiles and characteristics out there about the psychological profiles of women. So this is just one example. One profile, you have the driven, active, and optimist woman. Another, you have the nurturing, conservative. The third, you have a planner, satisfied, and resolute. You have the loner, stressed, and uncertain. And then you have the woman that's open, social, and outgoing. And depending on which profile a woman is in will kind of dictate how you market to her. And remembering, marketing is basically just messaging and communicating. So in general, again, let's look at some of the differences. Women are more other-oriented, meaning they think of others when they're making decisions, and men are more self-oriented, meaning they think of themselves. Women process data more comprehensively, whereas men process data more selectively. So women want the big picture and all of the information. Comprehensive data combined with emotional connections seem to yield the best results. And for women, providing background information might prove more useful in terms of setting things up. Also, remember that women are cautious and respond also to negative data more so than men. There are also a couple of noteworthy differences. And these present in some specific areas, such as the shopping experience. So women prefer interaction with salespeople, and stores focusing on attracting female shoppers might place more emphasis on ensuring that sales staff are courteous, pleasant, and knowledgeable about the products. So women, when they are buying things, want to interact with other people that can give them information, feedback, etc. Another noteworthy difference is in gender identification. Women don't put so much emphasis on gender identity of products, and this allows them to have greater choices. So one very clear example of this is razors. Often women will use men's razors. They don't really care who they're particularly marketed to. Whereas it is very rare that you would find a man using a woman's razor, like the Venus Pink razors. Typically men aren't going to gravitate towards those. So these are some interesting differences to keep in mind. There are also clear differences in the brain. Neurofocus, a company that specializes in determining differences in brain stimulus responses of men and women, says that there are some fundamental variations in males and females. So for instance, female brains have a stronger connection between the right and left hemisphere. The way that this materializes is that their language and memory is very much in touch with their emotions. This is for women. Women also have a larger hippocampus region, which translates to better recall of detailed information. So that's likely why women want the comprehensive information, because they can recall it as well. When marketing to women, use loads of detail as well as emotional cues, versus for men, just keep it simple. So we're going to start talking about the transformation that's happening in marketing. One very interesting way of looking at this, again, because we're talking about marketing crypto to women, is what do women and Bitcoin have in common? Well, it's quite simple. They are both transforming the world right now. All right, so let's start to look at how. Before we do, let's look at the old versus the new. So what traditional marketing told us and what we're starting to see now in marketing and how it's changing. So traditionally, businesses and brands missed how a woman's identity intersected with her experience at each stage of life. So a woman's identity at 20 is very much different than her identity at 60 or 80. New ways and current information is showing us that what a woman responds to and purchases changes as she does. So when you're marketing to her, take that into account. Typically, and this is a statistic that reveals that maybe some of the older ways weren't working, 91% of women believe that advertisers don't understand them. And now we're realizing brands need to realize that it isn't hard to reach consumers with modern, diverse messaging that takes into account what it's like to be a woman today. Traditional marketing research relies on recall and language, both of which are centered in the conscious brain. So again, today we're more focused on that we need to uncover the deeper insights into what makes women tick. It's essential to blend traditional marketing research with other approaches and better capture respondents' subconscious. So traditionally we were looking at the conscious brain and only really speaking to that. And now we're realizing, okay, let's take what we learned in our traditional ways, but let's also put it together with some other things and new information that's available to us, as well as the changing dynamics of what it's like to be a woman today. Let's also tap into that subconscious a little bit. So in short, there is no special trick to female marketing. Just lead with humanity. All right, so let's start talking about what makes women today different and why it's important that we adapt our marketing efforts to really speak to today's women. If we're wanting to push adoption of crypto, we're basically going to need to, in our businesses, market to the women, and that we feel is really what's going to help push and grow the cryptocurrencies out into the general masses. So again, what's changing? Well, one, women are highly educated. They make up the majority of recipients for advanced degrees. So of the people with associate's degrees, 61% are women, 57% with bachelor's degrees, 60% for master's degrees, and 52% for doctoral degrees. Also, women's economic wealth is on the rise. In 2014, women controlled $14 trillion of wealth in North America. That number has risen to $22 trillion in 2020. And that doesn't even account for the nearly $29 trillion of intergenerational wealth set to be inherited by women over the next 40 years. So definitely a force to be reckoned with. Women are also rising in the workplace. There are more women in senior management as well as C-level executives. Women are also rising in the household, and the influence that the women have in the household and the purchasing decisions for the household are on the rise. Women are key decision makers for family when it comes to financial moves. 96% is the number. Women who have primary or shared responsibility for family financial decisions. So when the wife earns more, she's likely to make a much higher proportion of decisions about how the family unit spends its money. And remember what we just looked at, that women are getting more education and increasing their wealth. So more and more and more, all of this is leading to women making more financial decisions about purchases. And as we'll speak about later, that'll also go towards investments. What's also different is that women are more than ever having to be role jugglers. So women's lives have never been more complicated. Young achievers are having to play multiple roles. As mother or partner, they are in a highly feminine role. As a business person, they play a masculine role. And then with friends, they might have to evoke both roles at once. Women, in addition to all of the growing education and advancement in the workplace, women are still responsible for the kin networking system, meaning they're responsible for holding the family unit together. So women are still, putting together Christmas dinners and sending out birthday cards and making sure that the family unit is staying intact. And so all of the things that come with this, women are still responsible for. So when you're marketing to them, be mindful of these things, and you may be able to allow women to hang their hat on these things. Speak to them about things that are important to them, that you understand that you have to work and then you have to get your higher education and you're handling the finances and you're handling the family. So this leads us to the multi-minded woman. This is different than a multitasking. It's on a whole nother level. So Ketchum explains the perpetual state of mind for today's typical 25 to 54-year-old woman who must constantly deal with the multiple dimensions of her life. This is what he explains as the multi-minding woman. So even when watching TV, and this struck me particularly hard, even when you're trying to do your best to relax, at any one moment, today's woman is thinking about multiple things, from finances to career to spouse to personal to mother and children. So consequently, these women have moved from multitasking, from we're just not doing multiple things at once. At any given time, our mind is on a variety of different things. So again, when you're marketing to women, you can tap into these things in your messaging that, you know, I understand that you've got to think about A, B, and C, and X, Y, and Z. Also, it's important to be respectful of a woman's time, understanding that she has all of these things going on. So you really need to be respectful of her time and select your message in a way that's going to get to the point, still tap into the emotion, still tap into giving her comprehensive data, but being respectful that there's a lot of things going on at any one given time. So let's look at some marketing tips. We're going to breeze through these pretty quickly, taking the information that we've kind of laid as the groundwork. Okay, so first, do the research. Use the data to connect authentically with your audience and make points with facts. Also, take an intersectional approach. So marketing to women is less about gender, just for the sake of it, and more about prioritizing women and prioritizing people as they grow and change, understanding that their perspective is also going to change. Next, tell women's stories. So this goes very well with the prior tip that we just talked about. You can combine that data as well as the tap into the intersectional approach and where this woman is in her life by telling a story. Tell stories that aim to inspire and motivate. Don't portray women as victims. And tell stories that prioritize values. Again, that's going to be driven by that intersectional approach. What's their background? How old are they? Where are they at in their life? What's important to them? And so telling stories is a really good, easy way to tap into that. Also, use emotional messaging. This goes with the intersectional approach as well as the stories. Women are likely to form more of a lasting emotional attachment to products. Instead of presenting a lot of dry stats, show them why they need to have this item or have what you're offering to make their lives better. Also, use social media and social influence. Women are more likely than men to adopt technologies that enable customer engagement. So, for example, women use QR codes and social media like Facebook and Pinterest. And what's interesting about this type of social media is it allows for a lot of engagement. So I know for me in particular, I don't buy anything online or from anyone that I haven't done business with in the past until I read the reviews. And I don't just want to see if they have 5 stars. I'm actually digging in and I'm reading the reviews. So remember, we talked about women make decisions based off of comprehensive. They want all the information. They want the data. So by having reviews and this type of engagement is a way that I can make my buying decisions. So remember that your customers are likely doing the same thing. And also, in addition to seeking out that information, I like to share information about things that have worked well for me. So even if I'm not doing it on social media, I frequently text my friends, hey, try this product, try this vitamin, try this service. So even again, if I'm not doing it on social media, I'm using my social influence and I'm promoting other brands. And that's the type of customer that you want to create. You want to create the one that's going to be your cheerleader. So tap into that and create the experience to where your customer wants to be your cheerleader. And specifically, since we're talking about crypto adoption, that's what we want. We want to make our customer totally happy, totally immersive in the crypto experience to the point that they're telling all of their friends and their family. And that's how we're going to be able to spread crypto adoption. So definitely use this information to your advantage. Also, adopt a path less traveled approach to social media. So a lot of social media has become very saturated and it can kind of become very noisy. And on social media like Facebook, a lot of times people are already expecting and knowing that they're seeing commercials or marketing or advertising. So they may be a little bit more guarded if you're looking at things that are less traveled. So, for example, Pinterest in one statistic is said to be the third largest social network. So you've got to think outside of the box a little bit about ways how you can use these less utilized social media to where it's not so crowded and your message can really get out and start to resonate with people. And you've got to think of ways that is not traditional. So, for example, 85% of women on Pinterest use it to plan special moments. And then there's another statistic about 43% plan to get their ideal home within the next 5 years. So, one just quick example, and I'm sure you'll think of much better ones, is you can combine images of homes and vacations, and you can put like maybe a stack of crypto on one side and a beautiful home on the other, and maybe a timetable. So if in 2019 or when you got your stimulus check, you put that to the side, then you can now achieve your dream of having this beautiful home or this great vacation if you had to put that stimulus check into crypto at that time. So just putting that entire message in a picture on a social media channel that's not as crowded, you can draw more people in that way. Also, use influencer marketing in a way that drives true action or be your own influencer. So, we talked about when you're marketing to women, use stories and remember the intersectional approach. So, find people that are going to resonate with your target market, and having influencers is a great way because they can really use those stories and connect to people on those emotional ways that a quick 30-second blip on Facebook or a promoted ad or whatever wouldn't do. So if you can't get in touch with influencers, or if you're not at that point yet, then become your own influencer because a lot of times we build association with people that we see on screen. So you might want to start your own YouTube channel and get your story out there. And that way, other women can come to you because they identify with it. And again, ultimate goal is to push adoption. So we're going to promote our businesses and push our businesses and improve our businesses. And in turn, that's going to push adoption of crypto out into the wider world. So whether you are using another influencer or your own influencer, this is a way that you can market crypto to women. And then just in general, don't be that guy. Don't gender wash, avoid the stereotypes, don't go to extremes, don't pigeonhole women into traditionally feminine activities. Don't pink and shrink, meaning make it small and make it pink and think that that means marketing to women. Just because your logo is pink, that doesn't mean that women are going to draw and attract them and attract to you. So use the more nuanced approaches that we talked about previously. Okay, so next we're going to talk about unlocking the power of women in investing. We've been talking about marketing generally. Let's look at how that applies to investing. The financial services industry is undergoing a dramatic shift, and the next generation of investors will be younger and more diverse, with more with women taking a more prominent role in building and growing family and personal wealth. So we really need to look at women in the investment world. As women's economic influence rises to new levels, how will they manage this wealth? So what we're really going to focus on in these next few minutes is talking about recent surveys of women and how they relate to their financial advisor. And what it reveals, the short story up front, is that there is a wealth management gap. So I'm calling on all of us to fill the gap. Women think about money and wealth differently than men, and differently than how the current financial services industry is set up, meaning there is a gap, meaning there is a disconnect between the way it is and the way it needs to be in order to serve the women that, as we saw, are have more wealth and it's growing on a daily basis. So let's talk about some of what some of the gaps are and then discuss how we can fill in those gaps and as a result benefit in our business from it, as well as push and promote crypto adoption. Okay, so first, women save more. On average, women save 9% of their salary in comparison with men who save about 8.6. Also, women invest less. So one survey shows that women invest 40% less than men. So women are going to save more of their salary, and then instead of invest it into things that's going to make their income grow, they just save it. And whereas men are more likely to take risky investments, risky or non-risky, men are more likely to invest their money. Another difference is that women score lower on financial literacy test scores. So again, we really need to fill this gap. And I feel that we are uniquely qualified to be able to do this, because where the deficiencies are, we're specifically qualified to make a difference there. And please understand, in all of this, I am not saying that you are giving financial advice, because you do not want to do that if you're not a licensed financial advisor. But the beauty of this situation is that where these deficiencies exist, we are specifically and specially and uniquely qualified to be able to help and improve and fill the gap without giving financial advice. So how you say, let's talk about it. Let's go back to women save more. We really need to come in and take the time to speak with our clients and educate them and inform them about investments. So first, open their world up and let them know that there are investments available that they don't have to go to a financial advisor for, like Bitcoin, for example. So once we've let them and kind of opened the door to the possibility of investments, we then have to educate them and explain why doing what we've done for the past decades may not be working, specifically saving. So we understand that with CPI, your savings that you typically stored under a mattress is being eaten up every single day, that you're losing purchasing power every day that you're leaving your wealth within the dollar, your value within the dollar. It's getting eaten up and you're able to purchase less and less and less. And it is for this reason, as we talked about, the world is changing. So whereas the CPI used to be, what, 2%, it's now at 4%, and that is extremely conservative. So we've got to take the time to educate women about how these things are changing. And then once we let them understand how the changes, what the changes are and how it affects them, let's give them solutions. Okay, let's look into Bitcoin. Let's look into other cryptocurrencies. Also, with women scoring lower on literacy, again, this is an education thing. We can do this without being financial advisors. So taking the time to meet with clients, to consult with clients, to educate them on the economy and the finances and things like what we discussed is really going to make a difference there. So once we close some of these gaps, I think that it will put women in a better position, and it'll put us in a better position in our businesses for providing these services. So this data looks at why women left their financial advisors. So we call this apply the data and fill the gap. So the data says to us, women are not leaving their financial advisors because of poor performance. That's only 33%. The rest of it has to do with interpersonal issues. So 27% are leaving because of poor customer service, and 29% are leaving because of lack of a personal connection. Again, we are uniquely qualified to fill this gap. So luckily, we know based on our history with Bitcoin, or looking at the history of Bitcoin, that performance is going to come. Bitcoin is a growing asset class, and the performance is there. So we don't even have to worry about that. That's going to take care of itself. What we can really focus on is that customer service and that personal connection component of it, and remembering to apply the data that we learned. So how women like to make decisions, how women receive information, applying all of that to our business model, and make sure that we are really, really boosting the customer service experience as well as the personal connection experience that the financial advisor was not fulfilling. Also, a little side note, some financial advisors, because of whatever restrictions they're under, can't even really offer Bitcoin. So now you're offering women something that even if their financial advisor wanted to, they may not be able to give them. So again, not offering financial advice, just education and information. Let's open the women's eyes and show them that these options are out there, and then let's give them what they want and they need, which is that personal touch. So apply the data and fill the gap. This chart is very, very interesting, and as it says, it identifies opportunity. So identify the opportunities and fill the gap. This looks at, again, talking about women that were working with financial advisors, looks at their satisfaction level of items that they consider important. So top right is going to show that they're highly satisfied on issues that they consider very important. anything in the middle is kind of saying, I consider to the middle or right says, I consider it important, but I'm not being satisfied. So this orange box is really, really critical, because if you take a look at the things inside the box, it's saying the women aren't satisfied, but they still consider these things to be important. And what do we find when we look deeper? We find that these are topics and areas where we are uniquely qualified. We don't have to be a financial advisor, but our business model allows us to go in and serve these women that are clearly unhappy, tap into this market, give them what they need, and help them benefit and improve our business. So what are we talking about? We're talking about is a trusted partner, that they're not satisfied with that. We're talking about takes ownership of his or her actions. Can you do that? Absolutely. But women are not getting the satisfaction with their current financial advisors. We're talking about speaks to me in a language I understand. Very important, and you are uniquely qualified to do that. You know what it's like to be a woman, and you will find the woman that that you resonate with, and you will speak to them in a language that they understand. Let's take advantage of the opportunity and fill the gap. Treats me the same as my male counterpart. Ding, 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 ding. We can definitely fill that gap. Takes the time to understand my specific financial needs. Again, talking about the education and the information and taking the time to speak with your customers in a way that financial advisors, just based on, if nothing else, the way the system is currently built, they are not able to do. So we can look at what's not working and say, this is opportunity for us. So let's take advantage of these opportunities. Let's give these customers what they want. Let's speak to them. Let's speak to women, woman to woman, in a way that only a woman can, and really take advantage of these opportunities and create success from that. So here's another profile. In the beginning, we looked at one profile. This is a more current profile, and this is specifically relating to investing. Very useful. So you have your suddenly single woman, you have a married partner that's the breadwinner in the relationship, a married woman that is the breadwinner in the relationship, you have a married woman that contributes financially, and then you have a single breadwinner. So you'll notice that the primary objective of each type of woman is different. So it's important to notice this, identify it, and then make adaptions as necessary. So for example, the woman that's suddenly single, her objective is more about ensuring independence, whereas the married person, their objective is more related to retirement. And then the breadwinner kind of has to take on both roles at the same time. We discussed the importance of telling women's stories and understanding that their perspective changes as they grow. So determine which of the four you identify with, and that will give you an easy target because you can relate to your target customer and they can relate to you. So again, when we say marketing to women, we've learned and we know from our own personal experience, all women are not the same. So let's dive in a little bit deeper and see which women we're talking about. And then again, key, fill the gap. All right, so what's left? Just to do it. Now that you have a data-driven understanding of what women want, it's time to apply what you've learned to your own marketing efforts. This is a list of references used and cited within this presentation. So what's the takeaway? The takeaway is the change is happening right now, today. So what do you do with that information? Educate yourself. Make the necessary adaptations. Take advantage of the opportunities right in front of you. Again, can't stress this enough. The change is not coming. It's happening right now. So let's help as many women as possible so that they can take advantage of this change, okay? Take advantage of the opportunities that are presented before us right now. What action steps can you use in your crypto business? Number one, you are the customer. Identify how you perceive yourself, what marketing works on you, how you want to be served. We're talking about marketing crypto to women. You're a woman. You're the customer. See where you fit in. See what works on you. Take a self-assessment. Realize that. And then take that data. Step number two, determine which opportunities you can take advantage of and fill the gap based on your personal perspective. Okay, am I suddenly single? Well, I definitely know what that feels like. So I'm going to go speak to those women that are suddenly single because I understand their goals. I understand their objectives. I understand what's important to them. I can communicate with them authentically with data in a full comprehensive message, and I can be effective and I can help them and help my business at the same time. All right. So one, you are the customer. Identify what works for you. Number two, use the data that we've learned about today and based on your personal needs, and find that woman. Grab the low-hanging fruit. Number three, develop a written strategy for marketing to women. Include methods and messaging. So what's important here? Write it down, write it down, write it down, write it down. And then from there, make sure in your writing that you include what channels you're going to use. Are you going to be in-person marketing? Are you going to use social media? What channels are you going to use? And identify what you're going to say. What is your message? What do you communicate? All right, so one, two, three. You're the customer, see what works for you. Number two, use the data to determine which opportunity you can take advantage of. And number three, written strategy. All right, again, this presentation was presented to you by beautyofcrypto.com. If you need to reach out to Beauty of Crypto, here's the contact information. The next meeting, based on the time of this recording, is June 22nd. That's Tuesday, June 22nd from 7 to 8 p.m. Eastern. If you enjoyed what you saw here today, you can definitely sign up for our next meeting where we'll have more great information. We'll be talking about ways social media can be your friend or foe, and that'll be presented by Brenda Lotz. So again, our website, beautyofcrypto.com, is where you can find information on all of our upcoming meetings, as well as go ahead and RSVP. Again, her crypto night was brought to you by BitcoinSayWhat.com as well as BitcoinFirstSteps.io. So thanks to the sponsor for presenting this. And now it's time for you to take action. If you have any questions, comments, perspectives, if you agree, disagree, please leave those in the comments and we will definitely get back to you. Thanks so much for taking the time to visit with us today, and have a good day.